हेलो एंड वेलकम टू वीकेंड इन्वेस्टिंग डेली बाइट्स। वी आर शूटिंग एपिसोड नंबर 98। ऑन पॉपुलर डिमांड फ्रॉम मेनी ऑफ द यूजर्स इन द आस्क वीकेंड इन्वेस्टिंग राउंड, वी गॉट रिक्वेस्ट फॉर डूइंग मोर ऑफ बिहेवियरल स्लैश ट्रेडर्स माइंड सेट सॉर्ट ऑफ डेली बाइट्स टू हेल्प न्यूअर ट्रेडर्स आई सपोज। सो वी हैव डन दैट टूडे एंड वी विल हैव अदर parts to this series also later on. Let's first take a look at how the markets did today. So the market was, you know, a Z entertainment day. The stock went up 30-35% on the news of the merger with Sony, and the other major movers today were the real estate sector, where Godrej Property and DLF were up in double digits. So huge day for real estate, and you can see the 8.45% up on the Realty Index. I don't think we had the Media Index in this list, otherwise that would have been much higher as well. Some recovery on metal stocks that got beaten last week, some recovery in auto stocks, but other than that, the larger part of the market was quiet ahead of the Fed meet tonight. So the Fed minutes are awaited in terms of whether the Fed will be giving any more indication when they are going to taper, if the current monetary loose environment will continue for how long, any indication about, you know, tightening of policy. So everybody is waiting with bated breath for that outcome. And tomorrow morning, maybe a gap up or a gap down based on those global cues. So that's what we are looking for in terms of the markets today. In terms of the breadth of the market, was very good today. Mid and small cap indices were up 0.5%, 1.2%, 1.4%. Nifty Junior was up 0.5%, and Nifty, however, was flat, as I said. Within the weekend investing strategies, many strategies were up about 0.5% to 1.5%. Couple of them did not perform. MI25, MIATH were totally silent today. If I were to look at the monthly or 3-monthly performance, or even the financial year performance to date, we are quite satisfied with the way things are on most of the strategies. So what we are seeing actually is that a lot of people have been in fear of investing in the markets since last year, and 18 months have gone by and markets have given phenomenal returns in those 18 months. And if you have been sitting out, even a small exposure to the market could have given you some decent buffer to add more. So your first step has to come sometime. Even I'm saying, even if at the cost of, you know, this being, let's say, you know, today or this week, last week was the top of the market, let's say. Even then, I would say you must start to invest. Even if I say, you know, the next 1 year is going to be minus 50%, worst case scenario. Even then, unless you start to invest, you will never be able to start. So starting somewhere, having some buffer on your initial start, and then adding on and then adding on at each buffer, will give you that confidence to go ahead, and you must start to invest. So trader's mindset is very different from the strategies that we are having at Weekend Investing. So don't confuse between what we are doing as a research model portfolio product versus what we're talking here. I was a trader long time back, so these are recollections of experience from then. I don't really trade an intraday or positionally now, and I do only non-discretionary things, but a lot of people trade. So, you know, the same principles which help you systemize your approach are also applicable in discretionary as well as non-discretionary systems. So the first and foremost principle is to remain disciplined. Many people are chasing various strategies. Each strategy has a period of a drawdown. इट इज़ नेचुरल, एवरी स्ट्रेटजी विल गो थ्रू अ ड्रॉडाउन, अ गुड फेज़ और बैड फेज़, एंड दे विल कीप ऑल्टरनेटिंग. टू गिव अप अ स्ट्रेटजी वैन इट हैज़ गॉन डाउन एंड हॉपिंग टू द नेक्स्ट स्ट्रेटजी इज समथिंग दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डू. यू नो, यू स्टार्ट विद सम स्ट्रेटजी, इट डजेंट वर्क फॉर सम टाइम, यू लीव इट, यू गो टू अनदर वन दैट वर्क्स फॉर फ्यू वीक्स, डजेंट वर्क आफ्टर दैट, लीव इट, गो टू थर्ड वन. सो यू कीप हॉपिंग एंड यू नेवर एक्चुअली गेट टू योर, यू नो, strategy which you are comfortable with and which you want to excel at and then scale at. So, you know, remaining disciplined to one or a few set of strategies is very, very important. And I can tell you with experience that strategy is not so important. Your remaining disciplined to run that strategy is most important. So strategy is maybe like 20% of the game, but 80% is your discipline and your behavior while executing that strategy. Second point in this trader's mindset I want to talk about is staying away from crowd or noise. So there's a lot of chatter that keep happening during the day, you know, on various chat blogs, or chat sessions, or WhatsApp, or Telegram channels, so on and so forth, where everybody is giving their advice, and you know, everybody is trying to justify their advice, why you should be buying, why you should be selling. You must always remember that any price point in the market is there because there are equal forces of buying and selling happening at that point, and that is why that price exists today. So there is an equal number of buyers at that point, in the sense, equal in the sense, buying strength and a selling strength have are in equilibrium at that point. That is why that price exists right now. Like an example of Zee Entertainment today, which went up due to a news. There was no equilibrium to start with, so there was only buying pressure. And at some point, the sellers, you know, the auction was completed in the sense that the seller selling pressure also came through, and then it stabilized for some time before the buying pressure again took it up, and then the selling pressure came in. So a lot of noise can happen. You may be running your strategy. Your strategy may say, you know, buy Nifty, but you may get a counter view from somebody else on a Telegram channel or on the TV. And you may just, you know, give up your position because of that. So if you are convinced about your strategy, if you are disciplined about your strategy, just cut out all the noise, just like, you know, horse blinders, that I don't want to even, you know, discuss it with anybody. At that point, you can discuss your basic strategy with others at times to see whether, you know, there is any flaws in it. But once you are into your strategy, you are executing it, then no, listen to nobody. I mean, that's my belief. So third point is engage your action plan. So I have talked about this many times, that traders need to journal their trading. By journaling, I mean every day after the markets, please sit down, record your trades, write down what all you did, why you did, how it went, where you did wrong, what scope of improvement you are seeing, the strategies, maybe you have scaled up now, so the strategies are not working as per you, there may be a lot of slippages, there are a lot of costs, etc. So everything should be journaled so that you can look at that journal once a week, once a month, study it and improve upon it, right? So And you will also be writing down a lot of new ideas that are coming forth. So, you know, you are listening to a lot of people, you are coming across a lot of new ideas. So it is always good to once in a while, you know, test out those ideas as well and see how your strategy stands versus theirs. So I'm not saying that once you have your strategies, be totally blind to others, but from time to time, do also, you know, try to generate new ideas and see if it can improvise your own strategy. Fourth is very common in the sense that again it is linked to discipline. I would say that never cut corners. So let's say you are a long-term investor. Now, if you are sitting in a stock for a few years, waiting for that move to happen, and now suddenly at the first 20% move, you are saying, let me book this profit in short term, and then we will see for long term. So you've cut your corner in the sense that you were a long-term investor, you were waiting for since several years for your stock to start moving, and your exit would have been dependent upon some long-term event in that company or some long-term change in that company. But just a price move of 10, 20, 30% has caused you to cut that corner and say, okay, let me take this money. So that means you are not true to your strategy. You did not have a strategy to start with. So you just, hobbing between a short-term trader and a long-term trader as per convenience or as per whatever is being presented to you. So don't cut corners. If you are a trader, you bought something, your stop loss is 2% lower, and stock starts to come down 1%, don't, change your stop loss and execute it. Let it be. If you have planned for a 2% loss on that trade, if it comes, let it go. You'll lose 2%. But you can't preempt every time. If you start preempting your trade in stop loss or in, where you are booking profit, you will never be able to fully, realize the returns from your strategy. Number five is avoid the obvious. So a lot of times, there are a few things in this point. That one is, of course, some patterns, some things look very, very obvious. And once they start looking very obvious, you can be sure that every Tom, Dick, and Harry will be executing that. And they will not be succeeding most of the time. So when things become very obvious, some news which everybody knows, it has already been broadcast, it's already late. The stock has already moved, now latecomers are coming in. That is an obvious trade, right? So don't fall into the trap of running after an obvious trade. If your strategy had given you a buy at 200 rupees and now everybody is jumping in at 250, then you don't have to jump at 250 if you had missed at 200, right? So don't go after the obvious trades. Go after the trades which you are getting in your system. Next, number six is never break your rules. Again, it is very linked to the discipline part. Is never ever break your rules. If your strategy is not performing, you can reevaluate the strategy at some point. But within a trade, do not break your rules. Don't shift your stops. Don't change your profit positions. Don't change your position sizing. Just on the whim that this trade is looking good, so let me put 50% of my capital on it. So never, never do that. Don't break your rules. Write down your rules, revise them every now and then. Whenever you make a mistake, scold yourself, and you will make mistakes. Every trader makes a lot of mistakes. There is no perfect trader in this world. There is no holy grail. Please get that right. We are all humans. We will make mistakes. So once you have written down your rules and you keep improvising on your rules, you will be able to gradually sort of those rules will start to fit you like a glove, and you will get comfortable. Number seven, very important for investors mostly, traders also, that don't fall in love. This is a business that you are doing, and you should have zero emotional attachment to your position. Whatever trade you are taking, whatever stock you're holding, you should not be falling in love. You should not be reading so much about that company that you feel like, I will never leave this company and this is my gold mine that I should have. It doesn't work like that. It may work with some fluke for somebody. Somebody invested and that went 100x, 500x, whatever. But don't fall in love even then, because anything can happen to any company, any promoter, any segment, any sector. Disruption can happen. Everything can happen. So don't fall in love. Be analytical about your position, about your investment. Be rational. And don't let your emotions override you in terms of your investment. It is like a business. You are running a business. In business, if business managers and business promoters start to get emotional about their decision making, they will not be able to execute. Right? So don't fall in love. It's like I am remembering that famous line in Munna Bhai MBBS, where you know the doctor says that if I were to operate on my daughter's surgery, then my hands will start shaking, right? So because of love, because of emotion, your decisions will go bad and your execution will go bad. So don't try to, so make all efforts to not fall in love. Last point today is organize your personal life. You will be surprised what is the impact of your non-stock market life on your stock market life. It is a huge, huge correlation. If you are not, you know, mentally at peace, if you are not sleeping well, if you are not eating well, if you are not in the, you know, the pink of your health, this will all impact your trading in some way or the other. If you are tense, if you had a fight at home, if you have some other financial issue, don't trade then, because it is going to impact your trading and you will ruin your trade and you will fall further into that trap. So unless you are in a Zen sort of a mode, meditative mode, if you are not able to achieve that, don't trade. That is my sense. And once you are trading, and I have faced it myself in my early years, that trading tensions, trading stress can carry to your home also, right? So one should not be doing that. At least one should attempt to just cut out your trading life away from your personal life. It's just like going, you know, even if you're working from home, once you're done with your markets and journal and planning for the next day, and you cut off that period, then you know, from, it's easy to say than doing it, but at least one can try that. Not keep thinking about trading and your position all the time, and you know, your money gained or money lost, etc., so on and so forth. So that's how you can, you know, sort of compartmentalize your personal life, and that will really help you in trading and trading like a monk, actually. So this is all I had for today. I hope you liked the video. I'll see you in another video. Bye.